Hey everyone, it's State Representative Peter Schweyer here again. Of course, you know that because you clicked on my link and you decided to watch this video. First and foremost, happy holiday season to you, to your families. Whatever you celebrate, however you celebrate the season, I hope you certainly have a good one. And speaking of good ones, we're going to have a good conversation today. I think many of you have heard conversations about traffic improvements and safety improvements for pedestrians and for vehicles throughout not only the South Side and Center City Allentown, but throughout our region. And I thought it was a good idea. I was actually at the Mountainville Block Watch a couple weeks ago, and this conversation came up, and I thought it was a good idea to bring our friends from PennDOT in to explain of any of the projects that are going on in the Valley, but in particular, the improvements that we're looking to do on South 4th Street. You will hear it being referenced as SR 145, but for all of us who live here on the South Side, we all know it's South 4th Street. And we're really talking about improvements from roughly Emmaus Avenue to roughly Susquehanna Street. So that stretch. And if you've ever tried to travel on that 3:30 rush hour traffic, it'd take you 25 minutes to go from South Side to Center City. And so I've been working with PennDOT, who's done an exceptional job in moving this project forward. And with us today is a friend of mine, Mr. Ron Young. Ron and I have known each other for going on 2 decades now. He's worked with PennDOT for, Ron, you said 27 years, I think. Yes. And he's going to be introducing some of the folks from the project team that are doing this work on South 4th Street and give an update about where we're at on this $6.5+ million renovation to this key stretch of roads. So thank you all for listening. Ron, why don't you introduce yourself and introduce our team here a little bit?
Thanks, Representative. We have our District 5, just so your constituents are aware, encompasses Berks, Carbon, Lehigh, Monroe, Northampton, and Schuylkill counties. It's a pretty big geographic area and it's very diverse in terms of population, backgrounds, et cetera. So we are in charge of a pretty good area. And on behalf of our district executive, Mike Rebert, who couldn't be here today, he said to say thanks for helping us get the word out. I've been with PennDOT, like you said, for about 27 years. The first 3 or 4 years of that time was in our District 6 office down in the Philadelphia region. And I've been up here since roughly 2001, I would say. Or actually, no, before that. 2001 is when I got into my current position. But anyway, we have our team with us today for the South 4th Street project, or as you mentioned, we refer to it as SR 145, which is State Route 145. But the locals are referred to as South 4th Street, and we understand that. And our design consultant project manager, Megan Fallon, is with us, as well as our consultant designer, Jason Hursh. And I'm going to turn it over to them. Megan will take over and give you an overview, and Jason is the more technical end of things, and he'll get into that. And then afterwards, if people have questions, we'll take them, or if they have questions about other projects, we'll be happy to answer them as well.
All right. Thank you, Ron. Good morning, everyone. Like Ron just said, I am Megan Fallon. I'm the PennDOT Consultant Project Manager for the SR 145 Safety Improvement Project here in the city of Allentown. First, you know, thank you, Representative, for showing a continued interest in this project. That's very helpful for any project that we do here at PennDOT. So for this project, we received our environmental clearance back in June of this year, which kind of finalizes our project footprint. And as you just mentioned, this project runs from a few hundred feet south of Emmaus Ave, north to the intersection with Susquehanna Street and 4th Street, and then continues along 145 to the northern limit, which is with Wyoming Street and 5th Street across the bridge there. And the purpose of the project is to increase safety and improve the congestion throughout the corridor. And as we've discussed before, this project will involve a lot of ADA improvements to the sidewalks and ramps, as well as we are restriping to provide dedicated left turn bays at the signals and center turn lanes elsewhere on the corridor to kind of help alleviate some of the traffic. And it will also reduce the lanes themselves, which entails people to slow down and improve overall operations of the whole corridor. We'll also be aligning some of the left turn lanes at the signals, updating all the signal equipment on the 4 signalized intersections throughout the project. And finally, we'll mill and overlay the entire corridor to give you a nice new running surface on the roadway itself.
So Megan, if I can just interject real quick.
Of course.
So what we're talking about here are new traffic lights to keep the flow of traffic moving at a better rate. a bunch more crosswalks and to make it easier. You know, we have a lot of kids that live, you know, my oldest daughter just finished at South Mountain. My youngest will be a sixth grader there next year. We have a lot of kids that live to the east of South Poor Street over in that section of Mountainville that walk to middle school. And so as they're trying to cross South Poor Street, sometimes it feels like they're taking their lives in their hands because it's so crazy there at times. So you're looking to do that. So crosswalks for pedestrian safety, that'll really be helpful to those kids. The traffic lights, and then, you know, and then aligning some of those intersections. There's some weird ones where the roads don't exactly match up, makes it more difficult for folks to kind of get across if they're going over to McDonald's or what have you. And then you're going to repave the whole thing. Did I get that about right?
Yes, you did. You got that. Perfect. And I'll add, with those signals, a lot of them don't have pedestrian heads now. And
right.
we will be putting those in to kind of add to that as well. You've hit pretty much the highlights of the project. And one of the intersections we're looking at realigning is with the Price Right storefront. We're looking to line that up to better fit, so it's not kind of a jagged turn right there as well. And so this project is, we've transitioned into final design over the summer as well, when we got our approved NEPA, the environmental document. And at this point, we've submitted our final right of way to the district for review. And after that gets approved, they'll be signed and recorded, and we'll begin the acquisition process. And this is mainly for some of those intersections. We have to update some of the turning radiuses to make sure that the larger vehicles can make those turns that right now are kind of running up onto your curb ramps. After that, we're looking to get a final traffic submission that should be coming in this month. And with that would be the final traffic control signals, pavement markings, and signing plans. Other things going on in the project is we're continuing to work with utility coordination. There's going to be a lot of utilities run through that corridor. So there's a lot of work between PennDOT and the utility companies to make sure that we coordinate all of the things going on. And then this project is scheduled to let in March 30th of 2023, which currently it is scheduled for 2 construction seasons. However, I will be honest with you right now, there currently is quite a lag time for signal equipment and mast arms with just the state of where we are right now. Some of that could be up to 6 months. So with the spring let, that could play into our construction schedule, and we'll be working on that in this next year to make sure we get it down as and ready to go as quickly as possible. Currently, though, we're looking to complete this project in the fall of 2024.
So it's amazing to see all the moving pieces in all of this, right? So to somebody, I mean, I can't build a house out of Legos. So as somebody who is 100% not inclined from an engineering standpoint, I can't even speak today. Somebody who literally, again, I look at buildings and I'm like, I don't know what aliens built that. We look at something like this and you think, well, how hard is it to replace some lights and paint some roads and put some new macadam on it and call it a day? But what you're talking about here, and I think this is important for folks to realize, we're talking about a massive, it's going to look different, but it's still going to feel like South 4th Street. But at the same time, there's the utility issues, there's telephone lines, there's water and sewer underneath, there's electrical lines that are all going to have to be looked at for this. And really, this is a road that was built, you know, I don't know, decades ago, that really needs this rehab because the traffic patterns have changed and the buildings around it have changed. And you don't have, you know, sleepy neighborhoods on either side. You have that commercial corridor there, and there may be other, and you know, without tipping my hand, we are looking at doing a number of other economic development projects on the south side of Allentown that we're looking at doing this. So the amount of engineering work, planning that goes into something like this is extraordinarily long. It's not just, you know, milling and repaving it all. There's a lot more to it than that. And now with supply chain concerns, it'll take a little while. But when you use the word let, I know what that means from working with my friends in PennDOT. But really what you mean is that's kind of when we're going to start seeing dirt moving, right?
Correct. That's when we'll advertise a project, and there's a 5 to 6 week period, and then they pick contractors is awarded the contract. And so that the let date is kind of when that happens. And then usually after that, it's probably about a month before you start to see something happening.
Yeah, Peter, what will happen is the let date is we put the contract out for bids, and the bids come in, we review them, award it to the lowest responsible bidder. If everything's in good shape, they get what's called, we have a pre-construction meeting with them, and we invite local officials in. We'll be sure you're included in that as well. And then we give them what's called a notice to proceed date. That's the first date they can contractually begin work, and then they can get at it.
As soon as they begin work, I will not only be at those meetings, but I will bring balloons. I'll bring cookies. I'm going to be so excited for this to happen. I think some of you know, and I know my constituents know this, my district office used to be on South 4th Street. And watching somebody going northbound with the bank on the right-hand side, the Wells Fargo there, try to make a left and get my office, oh, dear God, I would literally turn and not face the road because I just didn't know if something was going to happen. Fortunately, we never saw an accident there. But it was always dicey. So we're all going to be super, super excited for this. So thank you for that. Ron, you want to introduce Jason and kind of go from there? Because I know he's got a screen to share, I think.
Yeah, Jason has some stuff to share with us. He's the more of the technical guy, and he has a good background in design. And I'll just turn it over to Jason. Yeah. If he wants to give you a little more background on himself, that's good, or he can get right into it.
Yeah, no, I work for Larson Design Group. PennDOT hired us to design this corridor. So everything you see is, you know, what we've been working on in the past months to get ready for advertising this project. I'll just give you covered a lot of what the project involves, but just to give you a visual representation of what the project involves, this is called the signing and pavement marking plan. What you see is signs. Everybody see that on my screen?
We can see your screen, yes.
Okay, good. What you see here is what the final condition of the roadway is going to be, with some notes in there and the signs oriented in the direction of travel. So that's kind of like, they look like they're backwards, but they're oriented on the plan sheet. We know the direction of the sign is facing the direction of travel. So that's kind of what you see. Some existing ones are shown here, and the proposed ones are shown in solid color. So in this area, this is leading down into traveling north on South 4th into the city right before you get to Emmaus Street. There's Troy Avenue, Troy Street. And then this is the plan at Emmaus Avenue.
So just to orient folks to this on Mass Avenue, the Dunkin' Donuts, if I'm not mistaken, is in the bottom right corner now.
No, the Dunkin' Donuts would be on the top left corner.
Okay, all right, I'm going to turn my head this way.
Yeah.
And I got you now. Okay, so yep, north is to the left.
You got it. So north is traveling left to right on the screen, is traveling north towards downtown Allentown. So this would be the Dollar General over here. I believe this is a CVS on the right-hand corner. And a Taco Bell.
Wendy's,
you got it. Yeah, the major improvement here at this intersection is a right turn lane being added to alleviate some of that traffic.
You get trucks hung up there all the time.
Yeah. Yep, and as Megan noted, all four corners are going to get new traffic signals, new pedestrian curb ramps. So, you know, as students are walking through this area, it's going to be a lot safer, a lot more friendly to the timing of the signal, and allowing the students to and any pedestrians to walk across the street. So that's the major improvement here. And then traveling north, the existing condition is just two lanes that are provided, one lane in each direction with wide shoulders. We're going to turn that into a three-lane cross-section with a center-left turn lane provided down the middle for the rest of the corridor. So you'll notice that starting there just north of Emmaus, and then it picks up here on the left, station 624, just traveling north to the right, continuing that left turn, center-left turn lane.
Now, all those stop signs that we see, just for the folks back home, that's not on Emmaus Avenue. Those are all the cross streets that you're seeing there. Yes. So, you know, Cooper Street. Yep.
That's all going to stay the same. It's shown as existing condition. We're not going to replace that sign as part of this project, but we're showing it just so that, you know, we all understand the traffic control situation for the area. And then the next intersection is at South Fifth. This does have some minor adjustments to the alignment of the road coming into the intersection for Brookdale Street. It's going to shift and align better with South Fifth across the street here. There's already a left turn lane there, but we're trying to make this movement through South Fourth to align much better for site distance and for, you know, just the general movement of traffic.
And for the folks at home, this is where Walgreens is at, and on the upper right hand corner is Mountainville Memorial. The Little League field is over there. It's that goofy intersection with that triangle that politicians put lawn signs up at that they're not allowed to, which is, you know, because it's in the line of sight.
Yes. Another point of interest here on this corner right now, it's a fairly straight right, free flowing right turn lane traveling south onto South Fifth. We're going to kind of shift that approach, make it a little bit more of a sharper curve so that cars have to slow down a little bit more, and provide, of course, fresh pavement markings and everything there so that there's a little bit more visibility for traffic slowing down, and especially for pedestrians crossing the street. So that's kind of just the safety feature that was added to the project for making the corridor more safe.
And Jason, while we're on that, also you can see the pedestrian head signs and pedestrian signs. The signs, there'll be a good amount of signs there too, also to warn motorists coming through there that they should expect some type of pedestrian activity.
Yes, exactly.
So, and skipping ahead, because I've seen these plans, the next spot that we see a major change is over at the Price Right, right?
Yes. So this is Wabash, and the Price Right property starts right here on the right side of the screen.
Yep.
Minor driveway adjustment there. But the major change for the Price Right property is they agreed to relocate their driveway from the existing condition right here, which will become closed, to provide a new access aligned with Linwood Street. That's going to greatly improve the safety and flow for left turning vehicles, both northbound and southbound traffic on South Fourth, making those left turns going to be a lot safer.
And you have the turning lane still.
Exactly. Yes. So they are going to do some more internal work as well, but as part of this project for PennDOT, we're going to provide the driveway relocation. And continuing north, not a lot changes in this next section. There's an existing signal here at Lexington, which is all going to be the same. We're just upgrading all the signal equipment and providing new curb ramps on all four corners, new pedestrian push buttons and all that to just improve the visibility and safety primarily for the pedestrians here. No new turning lanes or anything at this intersection.
Yeah, but for the number of kids that go to that McDonald's, that's going to be big.
Yes. Yes. And you might notice there's three crosswalks. And that would be kind of the baseline for what we try to provide at an intersection. If four movements, pedestrians, there's no pedestrian movement across this leg of the intersection. And that's primarily because there's not that much of a refuge and it's a longer distance to cross. So we did, and we matched the existing conditions of providing three legs of cross walk for that intersection. And then moving on, continuing that center left turn lane down through to Juniata Street to the existing, what's now an existing condition of Wawa being constructed. I'm not sure if they completed yet, but
not completed yet, but you see the retaining wall, it looks fantastic.
Yes. That's great. So we show some of their improvements as well through this intersection. And
a reminder to our folks at home, Wawa paid for that.
Yes, not part of this project. So they provide the right turn lane traveling northbound, and then they provided an internal right turn lane to access their driveway traveling east on Susquehanna Street. So that was a part of their project. And what we did is, as we had talked about earlier, at this intersection particularly, the alignment of the east and west through lanes was not great at this intersection. And similarly, north and south was not the ideal alignment for through traffic in those directions. So what we did was provide a left turn lane traveling eastbound left to get on to the northbound South 4th Street. That's a change that is well worthwhile. I believe there's a lot of traffic backing up. If somebody was trying to wait to turn left, that would kind of back the traffic up onto the bridge. And so this left turn lane, although it's not very long, it will provide some refuge and get those left turning vehicles out of the through movement of traffic. And what we also did to provide that left turn lane here was we had to shift this entire intersection to the north. So there are some new curbs and sidewalks being shown about 10 feet to the right on this plan sheet from where it is today. So that's the most significant part of this project in this intersection is, just shifting the alignment of these lanes for mobility and safety of traffic. And then this here crosswalk on the northbound approach was not provided. And we even noticed, in our field visits earlier this summer, people would pretty regularly cross the road onto this existing island that's there and make that crossing movement anyway. And with the construction of the Wawa, we all agreed, providing that crosswalk in this area particularly was going to be a benefit for safety for pedestrians. So we have, the three legs crossing the intersections here for the crosswalks.
Very good. And then now we actually had a little bit of extra money left over, if I'm not mistaken. So we were able to go along, cross the bridge, over the railroad tracks in the creek, and go out towards Good Shepherd, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
That's right. Yes. This is the last plan sheet that has significant changes on it, with the bridge being on the left side. No changes there construction-wise, but as you come into the intersection with South 4th Street or South 5th Street here on the left top of the screen, we provide a left turn lane here for refuge for vehicles turning left. And then the existing condition, the sidewalk extends along, I think it might have been a previous alignment, South 5th. We made this area to have a similar cross section as the rest of the corridor, with sidewalk and curbing provided along South 4th. So now there'll be kind of like an open parking area between new curb line and sidewalk that connects to the existing in both sides. But this intersection particularly would be a lot safer, a lot more consistent with the rest of the corridor for crossing with curb ramps and sidewalk right directly connected to one another. So
yeah, if you're coming along Trout Creek Park and you're trying to come out there and bang a right and go across that bridge, that's a sharp left coupled with a hairpin right turn, which is great when you're 16 and just learning how to drive and trying not to get pulled over there, which, okay, I did when I think I was 17 at the time. It is just an awful intersection. So all these are going to be really helpful. Plus, with all of our residents at Good Shepherd, it's going to be very important for those folks as well. I know that our friends with the Allentown Fire Department, all of the ambulances that go in and out of Good Shepherd, I think it's just going to be super helpful for everyone. Mm-hmm. And it's part of this project that I didn't, honestly, when we first started talking about that with PennDOT and Planning Commission. I didn't think about going that way. I thought about, and I think most people thought about continuing straight on South 4th Street as it turns into Basin and 3rd and all that other sort of stuff and going from there. But we're going to talk about that in another chat. The one last thing, because we're going to wrap it up because we're running a little long. I appreciate the fact that we're running long, candidly, because there's so much good information here. And it is going to be such a change for our folks that live in that section of town. And frankly, anybody that's coming off of 78 going into Center City to go to a hockey game or what have you, that it's really going to be very important. With all of that said, and just sort of wrapping up, the one hope that I had, and this is maybe me lobbying a little bit to our friends at PennDOT, you know, if you are going 78 and get off at the Summit Lawn exit and go down Pike Street and turns into South 4th, and then it turns into Basin, then it turns into South 3rd, and then it turns into American Parkway, and you literally never once put a turn signal on, and you're traveling. Ultimately, I think it should be our goal to rename that entire stretch American Parkway, because it really is part of the same road that ties in, the backside of Coca-Cola Park to American Parkway, which PennDOT is rehabbing right now, I think, along with the city. That section of downtown crosses what most people think is Martin Luther King. It's actually kind of Union Street, but that's neither here nor there, and goes forward. We really should rename that whole stretch American Parkway, but that'll be a conversation for another day. So again, just to recap, all of these improvements you're undergoing planning and maybe engineering. I could be wrong on that, but the planning and the utility issues and all that stuff is being looked at right now. You've come to agreements with the folks that own Price Right about a major change there. You've taken in consideration really, really localized problems with pedestrian traffic, and even things like tractor trailers trying to make a right going down the hill onto Emmaus Avenue and just getting hung up there all the time. I think this is an extraordinarily well thought out plan. It's a realistic one given the financial constraints that we have. It's still a sizable investment. I think the number is $6.5 or $7 million for that entire stretch. So the south side of Allentown is going to get some much needed love in this stretch. It's going to make our community safer and traffic flow better. I think your entire team, and Ron, to you and Mike and everybody at PennDOT, along with your contractors, have really done an exceptional job here. And we're all looking forward to hopefully starting to move that dirt in April, May, June of 2023, if I'm not mistaken. And we'll be there with balloons and cookies. Ron, you can pick the type of cookies, but if you don't say chocolate chip, I'm not buying.
I'm good with chocolate chip.
See, listen, this is government working together. This is progress. So honestly, PennDOT and your subcontractors, you know, you're the butt of jokes. I think they're always unfair. I think your employees do an exceptional job for us here. You know, it's funny, you mentioned, moving up here. You've been a local. You live in South Whitehall Township. It's not like you don't travel these roads yourself. It's not like you don't experience the same congestion and frustration that all of us do. And so I just, again, appreciate you. I appreciate our district engineer, Mike Rebert, for all of your focus on all the stuff that we're doing throughout Allentown, throughout the Lehigh Valley, and in particular this project. And so, folks, I'm going to wrap up this conversation. Again, wishing everybody a happy and safe holiday season, however you choose to celebrate. And once again, appreciate our folks from PennDOT, from our consulting team, Megan, you and Jason, for all of your incredible information and all of your hard work on this. And so with that, I want to thank my constituents for tuning in. We will have this video posted for a while. I'm also going to try my very best to get some of the graphics that we had before and try to put that up on our website as well. And once again, thank you all so very much.